For back-to-back consecutive years in 2018 and 2019, Kofi and I were named a Los Angeles power couple by modern luxury Angeleno Magazine, and we've been in other kinds of media publications and outlets. A question that we always get is, how do we really support one another, and what are some of our strategies for continuing to make our marriage stronger?
Happy New Year, everybody. It's January 1st. We are on our way to Terranea Resort for a power couple late lunch, early dinner. It's a power couple dinner.
Here we go.
I definitely wanted to make sure I talked about this in the vlog. This is something that has caught a lot of people's attention when I bring it up. And that's the fact that Kofi and I, every about 6 weeks, sometimes a little sooner, sometimes a little later, but every 6 weeks we try to connect, sit down, and actually kind of have a board meeting about our lives. I'm not even really sure when this started exactly.
Probably 2 years ago.
Okay, 2 years ago, yeah.
I think so, about 2 years ago.
And it's just something that is really great. It serves a lot of purposes. Firstly, you just get that one-on-one time, kind of like a date built into everything.
I've got the Spike Lee. This is like the Spike Lee cinematography. I gotta point that out.
Exactly. Yes, homage to Spike Lee too. Props there. Secondly, you make sure that you're on the same page with what your plans are. You get updates, you get more details about what's going on in each other's professional lives, and we help troubleshoot, problem solve, brainstorm, get new creative ideas. Actually, these sunglasses, this video is unofficially sponsored by Matsuda Eyewear. I used to write a blog called Luxury Thesis for Kofi's media publication, Celebrity Magazine, and I would get to review amazing luxury goods like this eyewear by Matsuda. So I just wanted to make sure that respect is paid because I love these sunglasses. Okay, one more close up for these sunglasses. Yes, 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 yes. Loving it, serving it. Right. Sorry, Kofi was feeling a little left out. He wanted to make sure that you guys saw his Costco prescription sunglasses as well.
Boom, Costco prescription sunglasses, baby.
The third thing that's great about these power couple lunches, because we're parents, it's also a good time to kind of debrief and strategize for the kids and talk about what's going on with them. I typically take the lead when it comes to their education and activities, but obviously Kofi's involved, and one way that we make sure that he is really on the same page is by sitting down and really reflecting and coming up together with the ideas that we have for what we want to see them improve on or execute on over the next little cycle.
Look at the sky, it's beautiful.
Beautiful sky, beautiful sky. All right, we're a little distracted. So thoughts from you? What do you have to say, sir, about power couple lunches?
Well, first let me get my serious brow.
Nobody can see your eyebrows.
No, I think they're critical. I think this has been a great way to just stay motivated. But more importantly, as a couple, just staying in alignment. Because I think a lot of times as couples, we're doing our own things. We're supporting each other, but not always on the same page. And this keeps us even more on the same page. So when the grind, you know, keeps you up late, I understand why. Or if it takes me out of town, you understand why. And we're just working towards those common goals. So yeah.
I think that a lot of couples over time, people say they grew apart. And I think that that's something that can be a real risk because obviously, you know, if you're not working together, especially, your lives are going in different directions with the things that you're pursuing. So unless you make a real conscientious effort to make sure that you are growing together, you could just naturally grow apart.
Exactly.
So, you know, just wanted to let you guys know about that. And we will be at Terranea soon, and I will pop back in with more video because it's going to be amazing over there. So yeah, we're just here. We're waiting for our table at Nelson's. We're also waiting for the sun to set. It's going to be beautiful. It is so gorgeous out here. It's a place we really, really love. And we are going to be working on the and talking about the ways that we can support one another in the coming year.
It's the first of the year, so we're coming for our date night meeting. We usually do a lunch, but we're gonna do a little bit of a dinner today. I feel like this is a kind of a home away from home for us. We come here quite a bit, just to powwow. Mimi and I powwow about what our goals are for the year. We do this every about 6 to 8 weeks or so, so we can just stay on the same page, support each other, have a good meal, maybe a drink, you know? But this is just a beautiful setting. It's an inspirational setting. The sunsets are amazing. I love the ocean, the nature. Can't get enough of it. So 2020, it's here, it's now, it's not tomorrow, it's here, and it's time to get after it.
Really, I think for me, my focus is going to be on accountability and setting some measurable goals, things that I can actually have Kofi, my accountability partner, check in on me about in the next couple weeks to make sure that I am hitting my goals, hitting my micro goals to hit my mega goal in the coming year.
It was a beautiful evening. We had a great dinner and a really great conversation. Kofi talked about his goals in terms of production and expansion for his real estate business in the coming year. I was able to talk about content creation and develop a strategy for how I'm going to put out content for the year. We talked about the progress of our kids, where things stand, but we also transitioned into a little bit more of a philosophical conversation and talked about what are the things that we might need to eliminate to make sure we reach our goals for the coming year. So looking forward to the next Power Couple dinner and sharing updates with you.